Okay, we're going to do a little herd behavior. I haven't talked about the herd too much lately. Damn. Fly got in the car. So, we're going to talk about, see if you can use your so-called critical eye and kind of understanding horses. And this is going to be boring for most people, so if you want to watch horses, and I'm just going to kind of talk about some things, explain the things the way I see it, and then hopefully you'll start recognizing these things if you observe horses, and then you'll figure out why things work and why they don't work with horses. I got a few crazy messages. That's Mr. T out there that he's kind of upset. I call this the dyke pasture because it's all eaten down. And he was in the other pasture for a few days and was getting too fat, getting a little crusty. So I pulled him off the big fat pasture and I put him on the dyke pasture. And a lot of horses have eaten this down, so there's not much to eat out here, which is good. I want him to drop a little weight. A few people ask me, why do I feed my horses when they have all this grass to eat? And why am I doing that? Well, if you don't supplement your horse's food and you just let them live on a pasture, you're not going to get your pastures to where they're going to be eaten down and they're going to turn into dirt. I notice a lot of horses are kept in what I call dirt pastures. And that's because they've overgrazed it and they're not supplementing, and people are trying to save money on hay so they don't feed their horse thinking they got all this grass to eat. Well, maybe they do. But by feeding them a little hay, you help supplement their diet and they won't eat down all the grass. So, Mr. T is still over here. There's Buddy. I'm kind of doing this from an angle here, so it's hard to tell where Mr. T's at. There he is. And again, his mare that he kind of is usually in his herd every night is over in that other pasture. So he's pretty, he's what I call stalking, or he's trying to get her attention, or he's trying to see her. And that's why he's hanging out far from the herd. He hasn't accepted or taken over this new herd yet. Now, herd dynamics, you see Mr. T, he's kind of bowing, he's kind of like he's got a mission, he's kind of walking over there, and he almost seems nervous or uncomfortable. Somebody may see that and say, man, that horse is acting weird. Why isn't he? Because I know that he's got his mare over there, and I know that he's attached to her, and she's in the pasture where he's looking. He's trying to keep his eye, or trying to get her attention, or see if he can find a weakness in a fence so he can get to her, see if he can call to her. He's seeing if there's another male around her, because there's a couple other geldings over there. So he's kind of upset right now, because he's kind of lost control a little bit. So he's pacing, and he's distracted, and he really wants you to notice where he's looking. That's where his mare's at. So he's kind of upset, which I'm kind of glad that he's moving back and forth, because he's walking. I mean, the amount of exercise that he's getting, and you're going to see that he gets during this video, is just a lot of walking, a lot of blood flow to his hooves, a lot of muscle building, a lot of burning calories, instead of standing around like Buddy over here that ain't picked his head up, because all he's doing is taking in calories, sitting on the couch watching TV. So Buddy's not getting any exercise because he's just eating, because he doesn't have that drive. Whereas Mr. T is getting exercise. He wants his mare. He's paying attention over there to where his mare's at. He's walking. He's pacing. His head's up. He's on alert. He is burning more calories, because even right now when he's standing there, he is not relaxed. He's not taking in calories, and he's not. You can tell by looking at that horse's stance that he's not relaxed. He is on alert. He is paying attention. He's got his stance on to where, hey, I'm on a mission, I'm looking. Just reading Mr. T's body language right there will help you understand when your horse is talking to you. Mr. T is talking to other horses right now. He's trying to talk to his mare. He's trying to get her attention. He's trying to see if there's another horse by him. He is communicating right now, and most people look at his horse and go, that stupid horse just standing in the pasture. What the hell is Rick talking about? He's talking. Understanding and learning what your horse is telling you. Understanding when he's telling you, I'm comfortable, I'm tense, I'm alert, I'm trying to get your attention, I'm trying to dominate, I'm trying to be submissive, I'm confused, help me, I don't understand what you want, I don't want to do what you want, I don't think you're strong enough. All those things that horses say, people never get it. You know, that they want, stupid horse is being stubborn, stupid horse don't listen, stupid horse had a bad trainer, stupid horse is crazy. They always want to, when you hear people saying that, your critical ear and critical eye ought to be saying, this person doesn't have a clue about horses. Because their horse is talking to them. It's trying to explain to them. It's trying to communicate the only way it knows how. Not with his mouth, with his body. Mr. T's head's up. His ears are up. He's looking around. He's looking confident. He's looking strong. He's saying, hey, I've got a herd. He's looking back to his herd. He's like, okay, I got a herd over here. Now the problem is that once he gets attached to a mare, Mr. T's pretty loyal. He's a good little herd leader. That he doesn't want to come off. When I've moved Mr. T from different pastures, he will like stare in the direction of his old pasture for like 3 days. Pretty much what he's doing now, he'll do that for about 3 days if I move him from a herd. And he gets very kind of, you know, that's all he knows how to do is stare where his herd's at. If there was no fences there, he would be where he's looking. He would be gone. So over the years, by watching him and understanding what he's doing and listening to him, I mean, it's pretty natural. He gets connected. He gets a herd. That's his girlfriend. That's who he is. That's his thing. Now, for some reason, Buddy's on the prowl over here. Oh, no. He just found some greener grass. I thought he was moving toward Mr. T, but he kind of is. He's kind of like, hey, what's Mr. T doing? So he's moseying on over there, closer to Mr. T, and Mr. T's drawing him. Oh, you see this mare behind him? Look at this mare. Buddy got him a mare. See that mare? He's drawing her in. There's only two mares in this pasture, and this little mare went over there and said, hey, where's Buddy going? These two are talking, and don't think that Buddy don't know this mare is following him. He may be going to Mr. T, but that might have changed. His first initial walk over there might have been, I'm going to go grab some grass. The grass is greener over here. I'm going to go over here. Mr. T's over here. And then as soon as this mare started following him, something clicked and went, hey, wait a minute. Maybe I got this mare. See how when he walked off, she walked off? See how he's creating that draw, kind of ignoring her, being aloof? He's drawing her in. And she's telling him, hey, I'm kind of interested in you. I kind of like you. You might be a strong mare. We might be able to work something out. So these two horses are talking right now. Most people would just see them as eating. They're just grazing, they're walking, they're being dumb, stupid horses. These two are communicating big time. Buddy, or now, for some reason, she kind of looked up. Now, you see her, she's kind of evaluating because she sees Mr. T over there, and she's kind of evaluating, where do I want to go, or should I go? Or is that horse that's looking, because Mr. T is still looking at his other mare, trying to adjust this at an angle here. Sorry for the jerks there. I can loosen this up a little bit. There we go. So now she kind of passed Buddy. See how she kind of went in front of Buddy and went, hey. Now she's going to see if she can draw Buddy. Did I lose my horses? There's Mr. T. And oh, I can't see Buddy. Oh, there he is. Okay, so see these two horses here? The Buddy and this little mare is kind of talking. Now, she may be just going next to Buddy to get over to Mr. T. I don't know. She may just be using Buddy to get to the big leader, Mr. T. But maybe not. I mean, she was low mare out here. I still think she's kind of low mare. There's only two mares in this pasture. So I've kind of told you who one of the mares is. So on the left there, you got Mr. T. Then the brown one with her butt to us, closest to the camera, is a mare, and then Buddy's in front of her. And again, they're talking, they're moving, they're eating, they're kind of doing their herd stuff. And you notice Mr. T, he ain't taking his eye off his mare in the other pasture. And he'll probably do that all day until something happens or somebody gets his attention over here, but he's just going to stare at where the last place he saw his mare's at. When you get your horse out in the middle of the woods and you're riding a long place and stuff, if you get kind of lost and you don't know where the trailer is, kind of drop those reins a little bit and let your horse kind of walk where he wants. He'll start looking. He'll give you direction. He'll tell you exactly where the trailer's at or exactly where home's at. A horse's internal compass is amazing. I've looked for that video. I'll look again where they use that magnetic draw on a cow and they actually change the magnetic field and they watch the cow turn and continuously face north. And it was pretty amazing. So their internal clock is way more advanced than we give them credit for. I'm going to go ahead and move off them because they're kind of pretty much set in their way. I mean, we could stare at Mr. T all day just staring at his mare. And again, he's got that look. You notice Buddy's look of eating, nonchalant, I don't care. The mare eating, kind of following Buddy, etc. Mr. T is dead on, hey, I'm on a mission. I'm working. Don't bother me. I know what I want. I know what I'm doing. I know what I'm looking for. Mr. T is not just standing there. Now, he's kind of relaxing a little bit. I can't tell. Maybe his back leg's a little relaxed. He may take a nap. He may relax while standing there. And I kind of notice his top line. And I talk about that when you're looking at a horse. That's a big cue to kind of what's going on with a horse. If there's a straight line from their butt to where their neck is level and their head's kind of hanging in a natural kind of sleeping, relaxed way, they're probably not tense. They're probably not paying attention. You notice Mr. T's neck has lowered. Earlier in his video, if you go back, his head was higher. Now it's kind of leveling out a little bit. Now, of course, the other horses that are eating, their top line drops down because a horse is eating. And normally when a horse is eating, they're not nervous. They're not too upset. They're fairly relaxed because they're eating. If they weren't relaxed, they wouldn't be eating. Horses normally don't eat when they're stressed, tense, or think they got a flight, or if there's a predator in the area. So, Mr. T's on a mission, so I'm going to go ahead and scan back over here to these other horses. If I can find them here. Now, there's only one mare in these other horses. So, we got a horse right here walking. And if you watch this horse walking, you should kind of be able to tell, besides looking between his legs, whether he's a gelding or a mare. And you'll be able to tell the other mare. By just watching their behavior, you can kind of tell who's doing a push and who's doing a lead and who's trying to move up. Now this other horse right there, see him kind of encroaching? See him slowly moving to this horse that's walking away? That's telling me the horse on the left is higher than the horse on the right. Because as this horse moves, the other one's following. Now, it could be that the horse on the left is a mare and the horse on the right is a gelding and he's trying to move in on her. Again, because I kind of know the horses, I see things differently because I know the dynamics. You got two horses over here. Again, you have one, two, three, four, five. You've got five geldings and two mares in this pasture. So, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Yeah, five geldings, two mares. So, picking out the mares and the geldings, you can kind of, now you notice this horse over here kind of got closer to Buddy, and Buddy stopped eating. Where's Buddy at? There he is. You notice Mr. T still on the job. He's a good boy. And then you got Buddy right here, who's kind of, notice that level neck? Notice that straight line from his tail to his mane to his head? That's telling me he's kind of sleeping. He's relaxed. He's not on alert. He's not really talking. He's not communicating. He's just totally, when you see a horse that straight line like that, you can kind of, boy, getting this camera on when it's zoomed in is kind of tough. Somebody's going to be whining. Don't be putting no damn message. Yeah, I got dizzy when I was watching. You need to put the show up. Get the hell out of here. I don't want to hear it. So Buddy is flat line right now. See that straight line from his tail to his neck to his head? That's when I talk about the flat line. That's communication. The horse is telling you, I'm relaxed, I'm sleeping, I'm not tense. You don't see that flat line on Mr. T. Where's Mr. T? See that flat line on Mr. T? It goes from his butt straight to his neck and then straight up because his head's up. His ears are up. He's looking. He's communicating. He is sending a message and talking, and it's just as loud and as clear to me as can be, And most people would see these horses and be like, I say, what are these horses saying to each other? Nothing. They're just out there grazing. Okay. So, again, reading. Okay, we got some more activity over here. Okay, we got this horse moving right here. Now, is this a gelding or a mare? Can you tell? I think I know, but we're going to see what's going to happen here. Now, let's see what this horse does. Walked over behind. Is it going to push this horse in front of it? If it pushed the horse in front of it, I would say it was a gelding. If it passes it and kind of says, look at me, or tried to get his attention or eye, then I say it's a mare. Because, see how she's kind of passing? Now, could it be a stronger gelding saying, follow me? It could. Unfortunately, I know it's a mare, so she's kind of coming in front of this other gelding here that's eating. The one on the right is a gelding. So she moved right in front of him, right in his eyesight, and kind of eating. What did he do? Now he's like, you know what? Let me respond to what she said. Let me move her and push her a little bit, and I'm going to move her feet because she came over here. So obviously she wants me, and I need to dominate her. So he pushed her a little bit, and now she's saying, you know what? I'm just going to walk off, see if he'll follow me. And he's not following her. And he's eating, and she stopped and went, well, that didn't work. He didn't follow. Now, we have another gelding behind here that's going to walk by here, and we'll probably have some activity here. This white horse is a gelding. And when you see him walk by this other gelding, because he's lower, the white horse is lower, you're going to watch how they walk by each other. Let's see if he walks by, because that's his little friend, the other mare. They're friends. He's not dominant, and he's not really her man, but they're buddies. So they want to stay close, but he won't if he has to go past a higher gelding. And the gelding in front of him is higher. So see, he's going to slowly try to get by this gelding. He's given this gelding plenty of room. He's walking by the fence. He doesn't want to encroach. Oh, did you see that little gelding? I think I saw that. The left gelding on the left looked at him, and he stopped. So they're talking. He's kind of like, well, I want to get to that other mare. And the gelding in front said, no, I don't want you by there. He stopped the gelding. He stopped the feet. He controlled the feet with a look and a glance. When you're working your horse and round pins and all these other stuff, that's what your goal should be. I want to be able to control my horse with looks and glances. I want to be able to control my horse with just shifting my shoulders or taking a step toward my horse or taking a step away from my horse to create that draw. I want to be able to talk to my horse just like this gelding in front here on the left talk to the white gelding. It was just a glance. He didn't have to pick his head up. He didn't have to swish his tail. He didn't have to get all loud. He didn't have to turn and show his teeth. He merely looked at him and kind of gave him that glance like, don't come up on me. And the white gelding went, woo, I'll stop. I got it. I heard you. I don't need a harder lesson. That's what people call respect. That's what people try to say, you know, is it fear? Is that white gelding scared of that other gelding? Yeah, he is. He don't want to get bit. He don't want to get kicked. He don't want to get chased off. Now, it sounds better if I call it, oh, that white horse respects the brown horse. And it's so sweet. No. That white horse says, you know what? I don't want to get kicked and I don't want to get chased off. So I'm going to stop where I'm at. Because horses are comfort-seeking animals. And by seeking comfort, they avoid conflict. So if you're always causing conflict with your horse doesn't want to be around you. If you're always keeping your horse out of your space, if you're always shaking a stinking rope in his face, if you're always poking him with a stick, if you're always creating conflict with your horse will avoid you. He will not find comfort. This white horse found comfort by stopping and standing where he was told. The direction was clear. He knows his place. And he found comfort. Okay? If people could get that, it would make horses' lives so much better. But, you know, there's all this crap to sell and buy my video and buy this tape and do all this other crap. You know, people, do you know how many people would be out of business if everyone understood a horse? Do you realize how much money and how much gear I couldn't sell with my name on it and how much damn catalogs I couldn't put out with my little pink and purple shirt with a little horsey on it, or a little this on it, or Down Under Horsemanship, or DH, or Pat Pirelli, or John Lines, or Perfect Horse, whatever the little cliche they got out there. Do you know how much money they would lose if people understood horses? I mean, sometimes I feel like the mass magician. And so this horse has moved off here. And watch this white one. He's going to take a step, say, okay, he gave me a little space, so I think I can come in. So this white horse, he had one step. He may take another step. Now, that front horse walked another horse. There's the female horse in front of him. Where is it? All right, now he's in the video. See that white horse? Took a step in, moved in. Because the other horse kind of walked away and said, it's okay to come in. He created space and distance, which expanded the comfort zone of the white horse. And the white horse says, okay, I'll take a step. Okay, so that horse took another step. Now, these three horses here, the one on the left is a mare. The one in the middle is the high gelding. And the white one is the lower gelding of this little, what I call a subherd. So these three horses are talking. Even though it looks like they're just eating, they're not. And if you can't understand that they're talking and learn how to read them, then you're never going to understand how to talk to your horse with your body, with your look, with your subtle glance and your small changes by getting bigger, by putting your shoulders back, by raising your elbows, by looking at them and raising your head, by moving quickly and raising your head versus slowly moving your head like it's a nonchalant, how are you doing? Just by moving my head the way I look at a horse will tell a horse what I'm saying. If I look at a horse quick and move head, that's usually warning, threat, pay attention. And if you look at most people handling horses, they're always yelling and warning and moving fast and saying pay attention. So the horse learns to ignore that. Okay, white gelding's kind of moving in. Here we go. We're going to see if we're going to walk by here. See if we see some air. See if he's going to make a pass. He didn't get any resistance. The brown horse didn't tell him not to. So he went ahead and walked by. He didn't encroach on his space. He didn't get too close. He didn't try to push or move him, but he was allowed to walk by that horse. Okay, now the other gelding's moving in. What are we going to do here? Moved in a little bit closer. Is he going to make the white horse? But he said, you know what? I want to get in front of you. You know why that brown horse went in front of that white horse? Because he can. Because he wanted to say, I get to go where I want because I'm high horse. He's telling the white horse, you can't tell me where to go. I let you walk where you walked. But guess what? I'm going to walk in front of you, and I'm going to walk where I want, and you better not tell me no. They are communicating and talking and carrying on conversations all the time, and most people don't get it. And it's boring, and there's nothing exciting about this, and I can't really sell anything on this, because if somebody figured out a way to sell something about herd behavior, then they would be doing it. Okay, putting little bells and putting little... You can communicate with your horse, and I got a new speaker to where if you put this fly mask on, you can actually talk to your horse while he's in pasture, and he'll love you, and this little radio signal will just let you talk to your horse while you're at home, and you can say hi to him, and it, whatever crazy crap that's out in the horse world right now. All right, I think we're getting close to 20 minutes here. I can barely see the time. Maybe we're over 20. All right, so hopefully you kind of get what's going on here. You see the communication between these horses. I'll go back to Buddy back here in the... Where's Buddy at? He's by that barn. Let's see if I can find Buddy. Buddy, Mr. T, what the hell are you guys doing back there? All right, so there's Buddy. He's relaxing. Mr. T kind of went over and got something to eat because he got tired of standing on guard. But you notice Mr. T is standing between the little mare and Buddy, because he's higher, because he can, because he gets to go where he wants. And that little mare is probably saying, oh, I know which one's higher. Because if Buddy was higher, he wouldn't let Mr. T get in between him. Buddy's the blonde one on the right. Oh, something just happened there. I couldn't tell. See, that head kind of went up quick. There was communication there. I couldn't see because I'm looking at an angle. Maybe I'll see it when I upload it. But there was communication, and that little mare threw her head up quickly like, oh, pay attention. I heard something. Somebody's talking to me. And, of course, Mr. T... got a little snack, went over. I can't tell if he's getting a drink or if he's probably looking at his mare. Poor Mr. T. I took his girlfriend. He's like, damn, freaking people leave me alone. Let me. Oh, we got all kind of, we got some issues here. I don't know what the hell happened here, but that he told her move, and she went no problem. I don't know if I caught all that on video or if I lost it. But I saw Mr. T, and if you look, if you go back, you can definitely tell when Mr. T was talking and saying, don't mess around. And he just told her, and she went, okay, I'm out of here. I got it. So she's going back to her high mare. And she's not panicked or scared. She just figured, you know what? I'm going to go over here where it's comfort. I was being made uncomfortable there. Mr. T moved me, and I didn't like that. So I'm coming back to where I feel comfortable. Kind of going to come in there and kind of say hi to her gelding. Kind of wanted, maybe she just saw my truck over here and kind of went, what the hell is that truck doing over here? But some people will say that that's a little mare, and why would a gelding, why would Mr. T run that horse off? Well, because he can. Because he's high gelding, and he believes that as a high gelding, I allow you to be with me or I push you away from me. You do not just come into my space. You do not come into my herd area. You do not come into my area of control unless, one, I invite you in, or two, you ask very politely by standing on the outside of my herd, looking in, and dropping your head. And when you stare at me long enough to where I think you're committed and you earn the right to get into my herd, then I'll let you in. Mr. T doesn't play when it comes to making horses respect him. No more than if you don't make Mr. T respect you, he don't play with you either. So understanding these little communication, understanding horses, watching them in the natural environment, trying to figure out what they're saying, why they're saying, Mr. T's looking because this other gelding is on the move here. Where's this other gelding? Now this gelding is low gelding out here. He's in the back, he's low, he's off by himself. He's a perfect target for a predator because Mr. T and Buddy's got their little herd, and these little horses here have their little herd, and this little guy's on the outside. Oh, poor horse, he's going to get eaten. Yeah, he may get eaten, but whatever. Oh, crap. I can't tell what my minute. Oh, I'm at 27 minutes. All right. Hope that helps understanding horses. Hope everybody had a good Thanksgiving. I don't know if people be watching this a year from now saying, it ain't Thanksgiving. Look, people, I load things up at different times. Don't be sending me crazy emails. All right, I'll end that there. Where's Mr. T and Buddy? Mr. T, you're a good boy. You too, Buddy. All right, we'll end that there. If I can get the damn off button. What?